यज्ञ एज अकॉर्डिंग टू यू, अकॉर्डिंग टू द यज्ञ, मनी कैन परचेज द हाइजीनिक कंडीशंस, हाइजीनिक एनवायरमेंट, परचेज द सोशल सिक्योरिटीज, इट गिव्स इक्वल राइट्स टू द पीपल एज अकॉर्डिंग टू द यज्ञ. यज्ञ सेड पर कैपिटल इनकम इटसेल्फ इट कैन कंट्रीब्यूट इन इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट वेयर द सोसाइटी society having as a different demands, as we discussed yesterday, different people having the different developmental goals, which vary from a person to person, J.R. Jasleen, Amritpal to Surinder. So different developmental goals are there, different developmental goals are there. So person to person, when the desires, aspirations are vary, but all these aspirations, desires can complete to the per capita income as according to the J.R. Jasleen. But this is not possible. Money itself can't purchase all the things. Money can't purchase all the things. Money itself can't purchase all the. मैंने कहा अलग अलग डिमांड है हमारी. जया की डिमांड है, अगर हम अमृतपाल की ओर सोचें, अमृतपाल वॉन्ट टू बिकम एज अ फेमस ऑन सोशल मीडिया. जसलीन वॉन्ट टू क्रैक द एनटीएससी. जया ढिंगरा इज अ सैटिस्फाइड विद द 60-70-80% मार्क्स. क्लियर? My developmental goal, all those individuals which are learning in my class, either as a online and offline, they have to score as a good marks in a 10th level in social. ये मेरा developmental goal है, which has varied from person to person. मेरा question ये था, per capita income, money itself can buy all the things. आपने कहा हाँ जी, आपने कहा हाँ. So बहुत सारे ऐसे developmental goals हैं which are not possible to purchase with the help of a money, for which we have to emphasize over the social indicators also. As we discussed yesterday, sit down. When World Bank categorizes the world economy based upon a per capita income, the income of the country, J.R. Dhingra, please pay attention, please. हाँ जी. नहीं बताना, उन्हें बहुत कुछ पता है. ठीक है ना? So World Bank said, yes, yeah. मैं आपने मेरा 90% होगा. 90s above, very good. Then prove it. When World Bank, why do we criticize the classification given by the World Bank? J.R. Dhingra, why do we criticize the categorization of a world economy given by the World Bank? Are you favor it? You favor? Are you J.R. Dhingra? Amritpal? She will answer. हम जनरली कहते हैं वर्ल्ड बैंक ने जो क्लासिफिकेशन की वर्ल्ड की तीन पार्ट्स में, डेवलप कंट्रीज, अंडर डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज एंड डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज. ठीक है ना? बेस्ड अपॉन अ पर कैपिटा इनकम. मोस्ट ऑफ द इकोनॉमिस्ट जो पढ़ते हैं, इकोनॉमिक्स पढ़ते हैं, लिखते हैं, वो क्रिटिसाइज करते हैं वर्ल्ड बैंक ने जो कैटेगराइज किया, इट इज नॉट एज अ जस्टिफाइड. व्हाई? Why do they criticize the World Bank's classification is not authentic? Authentic क्यों नहीं? Authentic word जो approved नहीं है हर जगह. If your goal is a 90 above, then you have to mastery over the subject, that particular chapter. And tomorrow is your test, revision test. Still you. कारण क्या है? Because per capita income is unequally distributed over the earth. It has associated with the resources. Sit down. Natural resources. Mostly the such economies are developed where the maximum number of resources are there, but the human resources are lesser. अगर हम गल्फ कंट्रीज की बात करें, अमेरिका, कनाडा, रशिया की बात करें, यहाँ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स कम है, पॉपुलेशन कम है, पर उससे कंपेरेटिवली रिसोर्सेज ज्यादा है. ठीक है ना? इन इकोनॉमीज में रिसोर्सेज आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर देयर डेवलपमेंट. वेन वी टॉकिंग अबाउट इन कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ इंडिया, देयर आर द population resources are more as compared to the population resource. Natural resources are also there, but they are not above of the availability of a human resource. Agar hum balance dekhe to population high hai to resources bhi zyada hai. Theek hai na? Usse karan India is considered as a developing. Agar aisi condition hoti, India mein resources kam hote, agriculture akeli possible hoti, ya phir minerals can possible to available in India aur population zyada hoti, us situation mein India ek underdeveloped nation hota. ठीक है ना? इसी के अपोजिट अगर इंडिया में पॉपुलेशन कम होती और रिसोर्सेज ज्यादा होते तो आज इंडिया भी डेवलप्ड नेशन होता. हमारी पॉपुलेशन कंट्रोल नहीं हो रही है, इंडिया इज डेवलपिंग क्यों, क्योंकि हमारे यहाँ हेल्थ और एजुकेशन का लेवल अच्छा है. यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग एज अ हेल्थ, हेल्थ कैन चेक इन आवर कंट्री थ्रू द इन्फेंट मोर्टेलिटी रेट IMR, थ्रू द डेथ रेट, थ्रू द लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसी. लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसी, द एक्सपेक्टेड लाइफ स्पेंट बाय द इंडिविजुअल्स, ठीक है ना. सेम एज वी कैन चेक द एजुकेशन लेवल इन आवर कंट्री. एजुकेशन मीन्स व्हाट, व्हाट इट मीन्स एजुकेशन, हिमानी, व्हाट इट मीन्स एजुकेशन. You spend 13 years in a school education. You can easily explain what it means education. A person this is education. In since last 13 years you just able to read and write. Very good answer. Sit down. Yes, Simon P, your answer. According to Simon P, education is what? As Justine said, UNDP use two indicators, economic indicators, per capita income, and health and education, social indicators. Education means what? Yes, education. Shiksha. Are you consider yourself as educated? होंगे अभी 13 साल लगा दिए पर अभी तक कुछ नहीं हुआ. स्ट्रेंज शांतनु, योर टर्न ओवर. शांतनु स्टर्न लाइफ टाइम, वो तो लर्निंग हो गया ना. आई एम स्टिल एज अ लर्नर. व्हेन यू कंसीडर योरसेल्फ एज अ लर्नर देन यू कैन गेन द थिंग्स, यू कैन ग्रास्प द थिंग्स. अगर आप सोचो नहीं, हिमानी सोचे कि ना मुझे सब कुछ आता है, आपको सब कुछ आता है, एक सुप्रीम पॉइंट पहुंच गया उसके बाद आप लर्न नहीं कर सकते. हाँ मुझे सब कुछ आता है, मैं क्यों सीखूं दूसरे से. वो सुप्रीमेसी आ गई, जब वहां आ गए उसके बाद मेंटल ग्रोथ होनी बंद हो जाएगी. मेंटल ग्रोथ तब तक हो रही है जब तक नए कॉन्सेप्ट आ रहे हैं, मैटर आ रहे हैं, नॉलेज आ रही है, तब तक मेरी ग्रोथ माइंड की होती रहेगी. तो एजुकेशन इज व्हाट, वो आज भी वही है. वो तो लर्निंग हो गया ना, अपने लर्निंग का थ्रू आउट द लाइफ चलती रहती है. अपने दिमाग को मिलती रहती है, उसको एजुकेशन कहते हैं. अच्छा, तो बहुत सारी नॉलेज मिल गई आपको पिछले 13 साल में, इतनी मिल गई है वो पता नहीं अब कितनी मिल चुकी है, क्या मिल चुकी है. तो ऑनलाइन व्हाट इट मींस एजुकेशन, हर्षित सानी, हर्षित सानी, यस हर्षित सानी, क्वेश्चन आ भी वही है. यस हर्षित
सर, यस
एजुकेशन
sir, education is the process in which we gain different aspects and learn.
Yeah, are you consider you are getting as a different aspects, you gain the different aspects related with the life. As according to Harshit Sani, we gain the different aspects related to the life. Hame aa gaye hain life se related bahut alag alag cheezein par, kya pata laga, kuch pata laga. So simply we states that education is the all around development of an individual, all around development of an individual. All around development means from toe to top, all around development, physical, mental, social development of an individual. Aap jo gain kar rahe, jo learn kar rahe, this is a part of your education because your mental level it has improving. Jo aap knowledge gain kar rahe, social aapko society mein rehna aa raha hai. ठीक है, देयर इज अनदर पर्सन इज देयर इरिटेटेड पर्सन, इट डोंट हैविंग द एथिक्स टू डोंट हैविंग एज अ गुड एटिकेट्स और अ बिहेवियर हाउ टू टैकल विद द अदर, टॉक विद द अदर्स. सो सोशल, फिजिकल एंड मेंटल ग्रोथ डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल इज एजुकेशन. एजुकेशन हैज जनरली स्टडीड थ्रू द लिटरेसी. व्हेन अ पर्सन कैन एक्सप्रेस देयर थॉट्स इन एनी ऑफ अ रीजनल लैंग्वेज एंड डू द सिंपल अरिथमेटिक इज द लिटरेसी. लिटरेसी, when we are talking about the literacy in context of a country, any of a country, literacy in relation to a country has studied in ratio of a total number of enrollments, kitne bacche enroll hue hain nursery mein, jitno ki admission hui hai, and how many are there which left the school education. Leave it clear jya, nursery mein bacche ka admission ho gaya, most number of 30% of students they left the school education before completion of 10th or 12th. कारण क्या है? बिकॉज ऑफ पुअर इकोनॉमिक एंड सोशल बैकग्राउंड, दे कांट कंटिन्यू देयर एजुकेशन. So net attendance ratio, first two which we can check as a literacy in a country, net attendance ratio, net attendance ratio, clear? Net attendance ratio, total number of individuals in a school education, retention of a students in a school education, retention, वो लोग जो कि पूरी education complete कर रहे हैं, till plus two level. It has not marked as a college or university education, just only as a plus two level of education, because when a person has completed their 10th or plus two level of education, it is ready for a production, for which as a government has given the incentives in the form of a cheaper availability of credit on subsidies. Aapki 10th ho gayi hai, aapki 10th ho gayi, you can open your own source of employment, either your restaurant, your dhaba, your sweet shop, or any of the other source. Mobile repairing shop or embroidery shop, tailoring shop, a person which completed the 10th level of the education, because it can add some make possibilities for the generation of their self-employment. Now, below 15 is a illegal, above 15 or above of 15 is a legal. It's a working class. This is as a working class. In most number of a developed candidates becomes as a self-dependent when it becomes as a 15 to 20 years old. 15 to 20 years old, yes. Chalo, hum aage chalte hain. Till there any doubts, UNDP's classification. UNDP's classification, classification given by the World Bank. By the World Bank. Yes, any questions? Nobody? Yeah, yes. Chale aage. Now human development. Human development. Human development indicates the growth of a human resource. Growth of human resource. At which state we will call as a human state becomes as a resource for a country? Yeah, Jaya Dhingra. Which state we will call as a population? Existing population, it becomes as a resource for a country. Which state we will call that the population available in a country, it becomes as a resource? Yes. Mehul Bajaj. Punjab is a state. Mera question hai, wo kaun si state hogi jab hum kahenge population, jo existing population, it becomes as a resource. People as a resource last year bada hua aapne. Nahi bada choro ko. Yes. Answer. Yes, Mehta ji. When humans use their skills, technology, or education for production of goods and services, then they are productive. They become as a resource. Otherwise, they are the liabilities. They are a burden. They will assets when they are capable for a production of goods and services for society. Because through the production of goods and services, they contribute to an economy. Unemployment था, conservation ही unemployment था. No, it was वो agriculture, sorry, इस साल है resources. So human development indicates as a growth of a human resource, which has influenced by the number of a services which are improved by the government for improvements in a human resource, in which preferably as a basic services provided by the government of India for improving, for development of a human resource as health and education. Health and education and training. Health, education and training. Through the training, the person is able to use technology through which it can obtain as a maximum through available resources. Resources are available in the nature, but the apes, Adi Manav, unable to use them. But due to as the skills of a modern man, it can utilize the resources. It can use the substances which can be as a convert into as a resource, usable items. Sunlight available in a 10,000 years back, it was not usable by the apes. But now presently the humans, modern man has used the sunlight for generation of electricity, the solar panels. This is as to their skills, technology, clear? How is this possible? Because the government has investing their maximum resources for improvements in health and education. Such economies where health and education are not adequate, these are lagging behind. These are the underdeveloped economies, like Pakistan, where the 60% of our expenditure has spent on a defense forces. In our country, 40% expenditure spent on a defense forces. In Japan, they are neither invest the money in a defense. They are preferred to the health and the education. That's why the Japan becomes as a developed comparatively to India or Pakistan. No, Japan. Japan is the developed nation now present. Resources are not available. We can't produce a crops in a Japan as an island country. Natural resources, minerals are not found in a Japan. But still, Japan is a developed nation because it invested their resources for a growth of a human resource. ठीक है ना अगर उसमें ज्यादा इन्वेस्टमेंट हुई एट द टाइम ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस आर टोटल लिटरेसी लेवल इट वाज एज अ 46% अराउंड एज पर 2011 प्रेजेंटली द लिटरेसी रेट इन इंडिया एज अ 75.63% मेजर चेंजेस आर स्टार्ट्स सिंस लास्ट 70-75 इयर्स जस्ट रिसेंटली 70 इयर्स सो चेंजेस बिगिन सच चेंजेस विजुअलाइज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ India becomes as a developing, not as an underdeveloped nation. As Jasleen said, India has rights under the developing nation because per capita, no doubt, per capita income is a lower. Per capita income is a lower in our country, but health and education is a high level as compared to the Pakistan, Bangladesh, and other countries. Other countries. Till there, any questions?